formula to be y is equal to w plus, that means wages plus rent, plus interest, plus profit, then minus e. So that gives us the comprehensive formula for calculating national income. Wages plus rent, plus interest, plus profit, minus t. That's calculating national income using the income method. Then, we now go to the product or output method. The product or output method, as the name implies, is when you are calculating national income by the addition of the money or market value of all the final goods and services produced in an economy. When I add up the money or market value of all final goods and services produced in a country, what I get is called national income using product method, output method. But it is not as simple as I have just expressed it. Because if you are talking about the money or market value of final goods, that word final goods, or we call it finished products, needs to be explained. What do we mean by final goods? See, final goods are the goods that are ready for consumption at the final stage of production. That means you have finished the production process. Now it is ready to be taken to the market for sale. That is the final product. But that is actually not where it ends. But that definition also has not included certain other things. So the best way to explain a final product of goods is that product that cannot be used to produce further goods. So any product that cannot use it again to produce further goods is referred to as a final product. That's the final goods. So you can calculate national income using product output method. We only consider the value of the final product and not the intermediate product or input. So when you are now calculating national income using product method, this is the formula we are going to use to get it. If I'm using product method to calculate national income, the product method, the formula is I would get the value of the final product. Final product or what we call output. The value of final product or output minus the value of intermediate product or input. So you have the value of final product or output minus the value of intermediate product or input. The value of final product or output minus the value of intermediate product or input. That gives us the value of national income using product method. This method now will now become complex in the sense that how do you differentiate between the value of the final product and that of the intermediate product? Bearing in mind that the final product already contains the value of the intermediate product. Let me give you a practical example of this. We are all familiar with midday meat pie. Let me use midday meat pie. Midday meat pie in talk shop is sold for 100 naira. Okay? Now, this is the value of the final product, which is 100 naira, which is the meat pie. But when we are calculating national income using the product method, it is not the 100 naira that we are going to calculate as the value. Because inside the 100 naira is the value of all the ingredients that are used to produce the meat pie, which already have their own separate value at the point of production. So inside the 100 naira is the value of the flour. Divide to this every ingredient that are used in producing impact, the value has already been added to get 100 naira. So we want to calculate national income using the product method. We take away the value of all the intermediate product or input from the value of the final product. So if we assume that in producing meat pie, which is sold for 100 naira, if we assume that the value of all the ingredients that are used is equal to 70 naira. 70 naira. So the value of all India is 70 naira and the meat pie is 100 naira, it means the actual value of the meat pie is 30 naira. That's the actual value. So that's what we are going to use in calculating national income. We are going to use 30 naira. Because all these other things, all these other items that are mixed together to get meat pie already has their own value. I hope you are getting the point. So that's why the formula is relevant. The value of the final product or output minus intermediate product. So in a live examination question, you'll be given column. Value of final product output, which also is about to have saved. Then the value of final product or output saved. Then you have value of intermediate product or input. Then you know that when you are calculating, just take away intermediate from final whatever you get, you develop national income using food dot output method. Then the last method is the venture method. The last method.